This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. See, text insects from Latin insectum, a calque of Greek entomon, cut into sections, are a class of invertebrates within the arthropod phylum that have a chitinous exoskeleton, a three-part body head, thorax and abdomen, three pairs of jointed legs, compound eyes and one pair of antennae. They are the most diverse group of animals on the planet, including more than 1 million described species and representing more than half of all known living organisms. The number of extant species is estimated at between 6 and 10 million, and potentially represent over 90% of the differing animal life forms on Earth. Insects may be found in nearly all environments, although only a small number of species reside in the oceans, a habitat dominated by another arthropod group, crustaceans. The life cycles of insects vary, but most hatch from eggs. Insect growth is constrained by the inelastic exoskeleton, and development involves a series of molts. The immature stages can differ from the adults in structure, habit and habitat, and can include a passive pupal stage in those groups that undergo four-stage metamorphosis. See holometabolism. Insects that undergo three-stage metamorphosis lack a pupal stage, and adults develop through a series of nymphal stages. The higher-level relationship of the hexapoda is unclear. Fossilized insects of enormous size have been found from the Paleozoic era, including giant dragonflies with wingspans of 55 to 70. Flowering plants. Adult insects typically move about by walking, flying, or sometimes swimming. C-section. Life cycle of many flowering plant species on which most organisms, including humans, are at least partly dependent. Without them, the terrestrial portion of the biosphere, including humans, would be devastated. Many other insects are considered ecologically beneficial as predators, and a few provide direct economic benefit. Silkworms and bees have been used extensively by humans for the production of silk and honey, respectively. In some cultures, people eat the larvae or adults of certain insects. Contents. 1. Etymology. 2. Phylogeny and evolution. 21. Evolutionary relationships. 22. Taxonomy. 3. Diversity. 4. Morphology and physiology. 41. External. 42. Segmentation. 421. Exoskeleton. 43. Internal. 431. Nervous system. 432. Digestive system. 4321. Foregut. 4322. Midgut. 4323. Hindgut. 433. Reproductive system. 434. Respiratory system. 435. Circulatory system. 5. Reproduction and development. 51. Metamorphosis. 511. Incomplete metamorphosis. 512. Complete metamorphosis. 6. Senses and communication. 61. Light production and vision. 62. Sound production and hearing. 63. Chemical communication. 7. Social behavior. 71. Care of young. 8. Locomotion. 81. Flight. 82. Walking. 821. Use in robotics. 83. Swimming. 9. Ecology. 91. Defense and predation. 92. Pollination. 93. Parasitism. 10. Relationship to humans. 101. As pests. 102. In beneficial roles. 103. In research. 104. As food. 105. In culture. 11. See also. 12. References. 13. External links. Etymology. The word «insect» comes from the Latin word «insectum», meaning «with a notched or divided body», or literally «cut into», from the neuter singular perfect passive participle of «insectare», «to cut into», «to cut up», from «in», «into», and «secare», «to cut», because insects appear «cut into» three sections. Pliny the Elder introduced the Latin designation as a loan translation of the Greek word entomos, entomos or «insect» as in entomology, which was Aristotle's term for this class of life, also in reference to their «notched» bodies. «Insect» first appears documented in English in 1601 in Holland's translation of Pliny. Translations of Aristotle's term also form the usual word for insect in Welsh trichvil, from trichu to cut and mill, animal, Serbo-Croatian zareznik, from rezati, to cut, Russian niskomoy nasikomoye, from sek, sakat, to cut, etc. Phylogeny and evolution. Evolution has produced enormous variety in insects. Pictured are some of the possible shapes of antennae. Main article, evolution of insects. The evolutionary relationship of insects to other animal groups remains unclear, although traditionally grouped with millipedes and centipedes, possibly on the basis of convergent adaptations to terrestrialization. Evidence has emerged favoring closer evolutionary ties with crustaceans in the pancrustacea theory. Insects, together with Entognatha, Remipedia, and Cephalocharida, make up a natural clade labeled Myricrustacea. A report in November 2014 unambiguously places the insects in one clade, with the crustaceans and myriapods, as the nearest sister clades. This study resolved insect phylogeny of all extant insect orders, and provides a robust phylogenetic backbone tree and reliable time estimates of insect evolution. Other terrestrial arthropods, such as centipedes, millipedes, scorpions, and spiders, are sometimes confused with insects since their body plans can appear similar, sharing as do all arthropods a jointed exoskeleton. However, upon closer examination, their features differ significantly. Most noticeably, they do not have the six-legged characteristic of adult insects: Hexapoda insecta, Calembula, Diplura, Protera crustacea crabs, shrimp, isopods, etc. Myriapoda, Poropoda, Diplopoda, millipedes, Chilopoda, centipedes, Symphyla chelicerata. Arachnida spiders, scorpions and allies: Eurypterida sea scorpions, extinct Xiphosura horseshoe crabs, Pycnogonida sea spiders, trilobites extinct. A phylogenetic tree of the arthropods and related groups. The higher level phylogeny of the arthropods continues to be a matter of debate in research. In 2008, researchers at Tufts University uncovered what they believe is the world's oldest known full body impression of a primitive flying insect, a 300 million year old specimen from the Carboniferous period. The oldest definitive insect fossil is the Devonian Rhynchognatha hirsti. From the 396 million year old Rhynie chert, it may have superficially resembled a modern day silverfish insect. This species already possessed dicondylic mandibles, two articulations in the mandible, a feature associated with winged insects, suggesting that wings may already have evolved at this time. Thus, the first insects probably appeared earlier. In the Silurian period, four super radiations of insects have occurred. Beetles evolved about 300 million years ago, flies evolved about 250 million years ago, and moths and wasps evolved about 150 million years ago. These four groups account for the majority of described species. The flies and moths, along with the fleas, evolved from the Macoptera. The origins of insect flight remain obscure, since the earliest winged insects currently known appear to have been capable flyers. Some extinct insects had an additional pair of winglets attaching to the first segment of the thorax, for a total of three pairs as of 2009. No evidence suggests the insects were a particularly successful group of animals before they evolved to have wings. Late Carboniferous and early Permian insect orders include both extant groups, their stem groups, and a number of Paleozoic groups, now extinct during this era. Some giant dragonfly-like forms reached wingspans of 55 to 70. Began 66 million years ago, a number of highly successful insect groups evolved in conjunction with flowering plants, a powerful illustration of coevolution. Many modern insect genera developed during the Cenozoic. Insects from this period on are often found preserved in amber, often in perfect condition. The body plan, or morphology, of such specimens is thus easily compared with modern species. The study of fossilized insects is called paleoentomology. Evolutionary relationships: insects are prey for a variety of organisms, including terrestrial vertebrates. The earliest vertebrates on land existed 400 million years ago and were large amphibious piscivores. Through gradual evolutionary change, insectivora was the next diet type to evolve. Insects were among the earliest terrestrial herbivores and acted as major selection agents on plants. Plants evolved chemical defenses against this herbivora, and the insects, in turn, evolved mechanisms to deal with plant toxins. Many insects make use of these toxins to protect themselves from their predators. Such insects often advertise their toxicity using warning colors. This successful evolutionary pattern has also been used by mimics over time. This has led to complex groups of coevolved species. Conversely, some interactions between plants and insects, like pollination, are beneficial to both organisms. Coevolution has led to the development of very specific mutualisms in such systems. Taxonomy. See also: category, insect orders and category, insect families. Classification: Insecta monocondylia, Archaeognatha 470, Dicondylia, Apterygota, Thysanura, Diptera 152,956, Embioptera 200-300, Hemiptera 50,000-80,000, Hymenoptera 115,000, Lepidoptera 174,250, Mantodea 2,200, Macoptera 481, Megaloptera 250-300, Neuroptera 5,000, Notoptera 30, Orthoptera 24,380, Phasmatodea 2,500-3,300, Phyraptera 3,000-3,000, 3,200 Plecoptera 2,274 Socoptera 5,500 Raphidioptera 210 Siphonoptera 2,525 Strepsiptera 596 Thysanoptera 5,000 Trichoptera 12,627 Zoraptera 28 Cladogram of living insect groups, with numbers of species in each group. The Apterygota, Paleoptera, and Exoterygota are possibly paraphyletic groups. Traditional morphology-based or appearance-based systematics have usually given the Hexapoda the rank of superclass, 180, and identified four groups within it: insects Ectognatha, springtails Calembula, Protera, and Diplura, the latter three being grouped together as the Entognatha on the basis of internalized mouth parts. Supraordinal relationships have undergone numerous changes with the advent of methods based on evolutionary history and genetic data. A recent theory is that the Hexapoda are polyphyletic, where the last common ancestor was not a member of the group, with the Entognath classes having separate evolutionary histories from the Insecta. Many of the traditional appearance-based taxa have been shown to be paraphyletic, so rather than using ranks like subclass, superorder, and infraorder, it has proved better to use monophyletic groupings in which the last common ancestor is a member of the group. The following represents the best supported monophyletic groupings for the Insecta. Insects can be divided into two groups historically treated as subclasses: wingless insects, known as Apterygota, and winged insects, known as Pterygota. The Apterygota consist of the primitively wingless order of the silverfish Thysanura Archaeognatha, make up the monocondylia based on the shape of their mandibles, while Thysanura and Pterygota are grouped together as dicondylia. The Thysanura themselves possibly are not monophyletic, with the family Lepidotrichidae being a sister group to the dicondylia Pterygota, and the remaining Thysanura Paleoptera and Neoptera are the winged orders of insects differentiated by the presence of hardened body parts called sclerites, and in the Neoptera, muscles that allow their wings to fold flatly over the abdomen. Neoptera can further be divided into incomplete metamorphosis-based Polyneoptera and Paraneoptera, and complete metamorphosis-based groups. It has proved difficult to clarify the relationships between the orders in Polyneoptera because of constant new findings calling for revision of the taxa. For example, the Paraneoptera have turned out to be more closely related to the Endopterygota than to the rest of the Exoterygota. The recent molecular finding that the traditional louse orders Molophaga and Anoplura are derived from within Socoptera has led to the new taxon Socodae. Phasmatodia and Embidina have been suggested to form the Eucanolabia. Mantodia, Blatodia, and Isoptera are thought to form a monophyletic group termed Dictyopera. The Exoterygota likely are paraphyletic in regard to the Endopterygota. Matters that have incurred controversy include Strepsiptera and Diptera, grouped together as Halteria based on a reduction of one of the wing pairs, a position not well supported in the entomological community. The Neuropterida are often lumped or split on the whims of the taxonomist. Fleas are now thought to be closely related to Boreid Macopterans. Many questions remain in the basal relationships amongst endopterygote orders, particularly the Hymenoptera. The study of the classification or taxonomy of any insect is called systematic entomology if one works with a more specific order or even a family. The term may also be made specific to that order or family. For example, systematic dipterology diversity. Main article: insect biodiversity. Though the true dimensions of species diversity remain uncertain, estimates range from 26 to 78 million species with a mean of 55 million. This probably represents less than 20% of all species on Earth, and with only about 20,000 new species of all organisms being described each year, most species likely will remain undescribed for many years unless species descriptions increase in rate. About 850,000 to 1 million of all described species are insects. Of the 24 orders of insects, four dominate in terms of numbers of described species, with at least 3 million species included in Coleoptera, Diptera, Hymenoptera, and Lepidoptera. A recent study estimated the number of beetles at 09.21 million with a mean of 15 million. Comparison of the estimated number of species in the four most specious insect orders. Citation needed. Described species average description rate. Species per year publication effort. Coleoptera 300,000 to 400,000 2308-001. Lepidoptera 110,000 to 120,000 642,003. Diptera 90,000 to 150,000 1048-004. Hymenoptera 100,000-125,000-1196-002 Morphology and Physiology. Main Articles: Insect Morphology and Insect Physiology. External Insect Morphology. A. Head. B. Thorax. C. Abdomen. 1. Antenna. 2. Acelli lower. 3. Acelli upper. 4. Compound eye. 5. Brain. Cerebral ganglia. 6. Prothorax. 7. Dorsal blood vessel. 8. Tracheal tubes. Trunk with spiracle. 9. Mesothorax. 10. Metathorax. 11. Forewing. 12. Hindwing. 13. Midgut. Stomach. 14. Dorsal tube. Heart. 15. Ovary. 16. Hindgut. Intestine. Rectum. 28. Thoracic ganglion. 29. Coxa. 30. Salivary gland. 31. Subesophageal ganglion. 32. Mouthparts. Insects have segmented bodies supported by exoskeletons. The hard outer covering made mostly of chitin. The segments of the body are organized into three distinctive but interconnected units, or tagmata: a head, a thorax, and an abdomen. The head supports a pair of sensory antennae, a pair of compound eyes, and, if present, 1 to 3 simple eyes or ocelli and 3 sets of variously modified appendages that form the mouthparts. The thorax has 6 segmented legs, 1 pair each for the prothorax, mesothorax, and the metathorax segments making up the thorax, and, none, 2 or 4 wings. The abdomen consists of 11 segments, though in a few species of insects, these segments may be fused together or reduced in size. The abdomen also contains most of the digestive, respiratory, excretory, and reproductive internal structures. 22 to 48 Considerable variation and many adaptations in the body parts of insects occur, especially wings, legs, antenna, and mouthparts. Segmentation. The head is enclosed in a hard, heavily sclerotized, unsegmented, exoskeletal head capsule, or epicranium, which contains most of the sensing organs, including the antennae, ocellus or eyes, and the mouthparts of all the insect orders. Orthoptera displays the most features found in other insects, including the sutures and sclerites. Here, the vertex, or the apex dorsal region, is situated between the compound eyes for insects with a hypognathous and opisthognathous head. In prognathous insects, the vertex is not found between the compound eyes, but rather, where the ocelli are normally. This is because the primary axis of the head is rotated 90 degrees to become parallel to the primary axis of the body. In some species, this region is modified and assumes a different name. 13. The thorax is a tagma composed of 3 sections, the prothorax, mesothorax, and the metathorax. The anterior segment, closest to the head, is the prothorax, with the major features being the first pair of legs and the pronotum. The middle segment is the mesothorax, with the major features being the second pair of legs and the anterior wings. The third and most posterior segment, abutting the abdomen, is the metathorax, which features the third pair of legs and the posterior wings. Each segment is delineated by an intersegmental suture. Each segment has 4 basic regions. The dorsal surface is called the tergum or notum to distinguish it from the abdominal terga. The 2 lateral regions are called the pleura singular, pleuron, and the ventral aspect is called the sternum. In turn, the notum of the prothorax is called the pronotum, the notum for the mesothorax is called the mesonotum, and the notum for the metathorax is called the metanotum. Continuing with this logic, the mesopleura and metapleura, as well as the mesosternum and metasternum, are used. The abdomen is the largest tagma of the insect, which typically consists of 11 to 12 segments and is less strongly sclerotized than the head or thorax. Each segment of the abdomen is represented by a sclerotized tergum and sternum. Terga are separated from each other and from the adjacent sterna or pleura by membranes. Spiracles are located in the pleural area. Variation of this ground plan includes the fusion of terga or terga and sterna to form continuous dorsal or ventral shields or a conical tube. Some insects bear a sclerite in the pleural area called a laterotergite. Ventral sclerites are sometimes called laterosternites during the embryonic stage of many insects and the postembryonic stage of primitive insects. 11 abdominal segments are present in modern insects. There is a tendency toward reduction in the number of the abdominal segments, but the primitive number of 11 is maintained during embryogenesis. Variation in abdominal segment number is considerable if the apterygota are considered to be indicative of the ground plan for pterygotes. Confusion reigns. Adult Protera have 12 segments, Calembula have 6, the Orthopteran family Acritidae has 11 segments, and a fossil specimen of Zoraptera has a 10-segmented abdomen. Exoskeleton. The insect outer skeleton, the cuticle, is made up of 2 layers, the epicuticle, which is a Thin and waxy water-resistant outer layer and contains no chitin, and a lower layer called the procuticle. The procuticle is chitinous and much thicker than the epicuticle and has two layers, an outer layer known as the exocuticle and an inner layer known as the endocuticle. The tough and flexible endocuticle is built from numerous layers of fibrous chitin and proteins, criss-crossing each other in a sandwich pattern, while the exocuticle is rigid and hardened. 22-24 The exocuticle is greatly reduced in many soft-bodied insects, e.g., caterpillars, especially during their larval stages. Insects are the only invertebrates to have developed active flight capability, and this has played an important role in their success. 186 Their muscles are able to contract multiple times for each single nerve impulse, allowing the wings to beat faster than would ordinarily be possible. Having their muscles attached to their exoskeletons is more efficient and allows more muscle connections. Crustaceans also use the same method, though all spiders use hydraulic pressure to extend their legs, a system inherited from their pre-arthropod ancestors. Unlike insects, though, most aquatic crustaceans are biomineralized with calcium carbonate extracted from the water. Internal nervous system. The nervous system of an insect can be divided into a brain and a ventral nerve cord. The head capsule is made up of six fused segments, each with either a pair of ganglia, or a cluster of nerve cells outside of the brain. The first three pairs of ganglia are fused into the brain, while the three following pairs are fused into a structure of three pairs of ganglia under the insect's esophagus, called the subesophageal ganglion. 57 The thoracic segments have one ganglion on each side, which are connected into a pair, one pair per segment. This arrangement is also seen in the abdomen, but only in the first eight segments. Many species of insects have reduced numbers of ganglia due to fusion or reduction. Some cockroaches have just six ganglia in the abdomen, whereas the wasp Vespa crabro has only two in the thorax and three in the abdomen. Some insects, like the house fly Musca domestica, have all the body ganglia fused into a single large thoracic ganglion. At least a few insects have nociceptors, cells that detect and transmit signals responsible for the sensation of pain. This was discovered in 2003 by studying the variation in reactions of larvae of the common fruit fly Drosophila to the touch of a heated probe and an unheated one. The larva reacted to the touch of the heated probe with a stereotypical rolling behavior that was not exhibited when the larva were touched by the unheated probe. Although nociception has been demonstrated in insects, there is no consensus that insects feel pain consciously. Insects are capable of learning. Digestive system. An insect uses its digestive system to extract nutrients and other substances from the food it consumes. Most of this food is ingested in the form of macromolecules and other complex substances like proteins, polysaccharides, fats, and nucleic acids. These macromolecules must be broken down by catabolic reactions into smaller molecules like amino acids and simple sugars before being used by cells of the body for energy, growth, or reproduction. This breakdown process is known as digestion. The main structure of an insect's digestive system is a long enclosed tube called the alimentary canal, which runs lengthwise through the body. The alimentary canal directs food unidirectionally from the mouth to the anus. It has three sections, each of which performs a different process of digestion. In addition to the alimentary canal, insects also have paired salivary glands and salivary reservoirs. These structures usually reside in the thorax, adjacent to the foregut. 70-77 The salivary glands. Element 30 in numbered diagram. In an insect's mouth produce saliva. The salivary ducts led from the glands to the reservoirs and then forward through the head to an opening called the salivarium, located behind the hypopharynx. By moving its mouthparts. Element 32 in numbered diagram. The insect can mix its food with saliva. The mixture of saliva and food then travels through the salivary tubes into the mouth, where it begins to break down. Some insects, like flies, have extra oral digestion. Insects using extra oral digestion expel digestive enzymes onto their food to break it down. This strategy allows insects to extract a significant proportion of the available nutrients from the food source. 31 The gut is where almost all of insects' digestion takes place. It can be divided into the foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Foregut. Stylized diagram of insect digestive tract showing Malpighian tubule. From an insect of the order Orthoptera, the first section of the alimentary canal is the foregut. Element 27 in numbered diagram, or stomatium. The foregut is lined with a cuticular lining made of chitin and proteins as protection from tough food. The foregut includes the buccal cavity, mouth, pharynx, esophagus, and crop and proventriculus. Any part may be highly modified, which both store food and signify when to continue passing onward to the midgut. 70 Digestion starts in buccal cavity, mouth, as partially chewed food is broken down by saliva from the salivary glands. As the salivary glands produce produce fluid and carbohydrate digesting enzymes, mostly amylases. Strong muscles in the pharynx pump fluid into the buccal cavity, lubricating the food like the salivarium does, and helping blood feeders, and xylem and phloem feeders. From there, the pharynx passes food to the esophagus, which could be just a simple tube passing it into the crop and proventriculus, and then onward to the midgut. As in most insects, alternately, the foregut may expand into a very enlarged crop and proventriculus, or the crop could just be a diverticulum, or fluid-filled structure, as in some Diptera species, 30 to 31 bumblebee defecating. Note the contraction of the abdomen to provide internal pressure. Midgut: once food leaves the crop, it passes to the midgut. Element 13 in numbered diagram, also known as the mesenteron, where the majority of digestion takes place. Microscopic projections from the midgut wall, called microvilli, increase the surface area of the wall and allow more nutrients to be absorbed. They tend to be close to the origin of the midgut in some insects. The role of the microvilli and where they are located may vary. For example, specialized microvilli producing digestive enzymes may more likely be near the end of the midgut, and absorption near the origin or beginning of the midgut. 32 hindgut in the hindgut. Element 16 in numbered diagram, or proctidium, undigested food particles are joined by uric acid to form fecal pellets. The rectum absorbs 90% of the water in these fecal pellets, and the dry pellet is then eliminated through the anus. Element 17, completing the process of digestion. The uric acid is formed using hemolymph waste products diffused from the malpighian tubules. Element 20, it is then emptied directly into the alimentary canal. At the junction between the midgut and hindgut, the number of malpighian tubules possessed by a given insect varies between species, ranging from only 2 tubules in some insects to over 100 tubules in others. 71 to 72, 78 to 80. Reproductive system. Main article, insect reproductive system. The reproductive system of female insects consist of a pair of ovaries, accessory glands, one or more spermatheca, and ducts connecting these parts. The ovaries are made up of a number of egg tubes, called ovarioles, which vary in size and number by species. The number of eggs that the insect is able to make vary by the number of ovarioles, with the rate that eggs can be developed being also influenced by ovariole design. Female insects are able to make eggs, receive and store sperm, manipulate sperm from different males, and lay eggs. Accessory glands or glandular parts of the oviducts produce a variety of substances for sperm maintenance, transport and fertilization, as well as for protection of eggs. They can produce glue and protective substances for coating eggs or tough coverings for a batch of eggs, called oothecy. Spermatheca are tubes or sacs in which sperm can be stored between the time of mating and the time an egg is fertilized. 880. For males, the reproductive system is the testis, suspended in the body cavity by trachea and the fat body. Most male insects have a pair of testes, inside of which are sperm tubes or follicles that are enclosed within a membranous sac. The follicles connect to the vas deferens by the vas efferens, and the two tubular vasa deferentia connect to a median ejaculatory duct that leads to the outside. A portion of the vas deferens is often enlarged to form the seminal vesicle, which stores the sperm before they are discharged into the female. The seminal vesicles have glandular linings that secrete nutrients for nourishment and maintenance of the sperm. The ejaculatory duct is derived from an invagination of the epidermal cells during development and, as a result, has a cuticular lining. The terminal portion of the ejaculatory duct may be sclerotized to form the intermittent organ, the aedagus. The remainder of the male reproductive system is derived from embryonic mesoderm, except for the germ cells, or spermatogonia, which descend from the primordial pole cells very early during embryogenesis. 885. Respiratory system. The tube-like heart green of the mosquito Anopheles gambi extends horizontally across the body, interlinked with the diamond-shaped wing muscles, also green, and surrounded by pericardial cells. Red-blue depicts cell nuclei. Insect respiration is accomplished without lungs. Instead, the insect respiratory system uses a system of internal tubes and sacs through which gases either diffuse or are actively pumped, delivering oxygen directly to tissues that need it via their trachea. Element 8 in numbered diagram. Since oxygen is delivered directly, the circulatory system is not used to carry oxygen, and is therefore greatly reduced. The insect circulatory system has no veins or arteries, and instead consists of little more than a single, perforated dorsal tube which pulses peristaltically toward the thorax. The dorsal tube. Element 14 divides into chambers and acts like the insect's heart. The opposite end of the dorsal tube is like the aorta of the insect. product circulating the hemolymph, arthropod's fluid analog of blood, inside the body cavity. 61-65 Air is taken in through openings on the sides of the abdomen called spiracles. The respiratory system is an important factor that limits the size of insects. As insects get bigger, this type of oxygen transport gets less efficient, and thus the heaviest insect currently weighs less than 100. The insect takes in oxygen while it is active, and small amounts of carbon dioxide are released when the insect is at rest. Diffusive ventilation is simply a form of continuous gas exchange that occurs by diffusion rather than physically taking in the oxygen. Some species of insect that are submerged also have adaptations to aid in respiration as larvae. Many insects have gills that can extract oxygen dissolved in water, while others need to rise to the water surface to replenish air supplies, which may be held or trapped in special structures. Circulatory system. The insect circulatory system utilizes hemolymph, a tissue analogous to blood that circulates in the interior of the insect body. While remaining in direct contact with the animal's tissues, it is composed of plasma in which hemocytes are suspended. In addition to hemocytes, the plasma also contains many chemicals. It is also the major tissue type of the open circulatory system of arthropods, characteristic of spiders, crustaceans, and insects. Reproduction and development. A pair of Semicircus grandicornis hoverflies mating in flight. A pair of grasshoppers mating. The majority of insects hatch from eggs. The fertilization and development takes place inside the egg, enclosed by a shell chorion that consists of maternal tissue. In contrast to eggs of other arthropods, most insect eggs are drought-resistant. This is because inside the chorion two additional membranes develop from embryonic tissue, the amnion and the serosa. This serosa secretes a cuticle rich in chitin that protects the embryo against desiccation. In Schizophora, however, the serosa does not develop, but these flies lay their eggs in damp places, such as rotting matter. Some species of insects, like the cockroach Blaptica dubia, as well as juvenile aphids and tsetse flies, are ovoviviparous. The eggs of ovoviviparous animals develop entirely inside the female, and then hatch immediately upon being laid. Some other species, such as those in the genus of cockroaches known as Diplotera, are viviparous, and thus gestate inside the mother and are born alive. 129, 131, 134-135 Some insects, like parasitic wasps, show polyembryona, where a single fertilized egg divides into many and in some cases thousands of separate embryos. 136-137 Insects may be univoltine, bivoltine, or multivoltine, i.e. they may have one, two, or many broods generations in a year. The different forms of the male top and female bottom tussock moth Orgia recens is an example of sexual dimorphism in insects. Other developmental and reproductive variations include haplodiploidy, polymorphism, pedomorphosis or paramorphosis, sexual dimorphism, parthenogenesis, and more rarely hermaphroditism. 143 In haplodiploidy, which is a type of sex determination system, the offspring's sex is determined by the number of sets of chromosomes an individual receives. This system is typical in bees and wasps. Polymorphism is where a species may have different morphs or forms, as in the oblong-winged katydid, which has four different varieties, green, pink, and yellow or tan. Some insects may retain phenotypes that are normally only seen in juveniles. This is called pedomorphosis. In paramorphosis, an opposite sort of phenomenon, insects take on previously unseen traits after they have matured into adults. Many insects display sexual dimorphism, in which males and females have notably different appearances, such as the moth Orgia recens as an exemplar of sexual dimorphism in insects. Some insects use parthenogenesis, a process in which the female can reproduce and give birth without having the eggs fertilized by a male. Many aphids undergo a form of parthenogenesis, called cyclical parthenogenesis, in which they alternate between one or many generations of asexual and sexual reproduction. In summer, aphids are generally female and parthenogenetic. In the autumn, males may be produced for sexual reproduction. Other insects produced by parthenogenesis are bees, wasps, and ants, in which they spawn males. However, overall, most individuals are female, which are produced by fertilization. The males are haploid and the females are diploid. More rarely, some insects display hermaphroditism, in which a given individual has both male and female reproductive organs. Insect life histories show adaptations to withstand cold and dry conditions. Some temperate Region insects are capable of activity during winter, while some others migrate to a warmer climate or go into a state of torpor. Still other insects have evolved mechanisms of diapause that allow eggs or pupae to survive these conditions. Metamorphosis in insects is the biological process of development all insects must undergo. There are two forms of metamorphosis, incomplete metamorphosis and complete metamorphosis. Incomplete metamorphosis. Main article, hemimetabolism. Hemimetabolous insects, those with incomplete metamorphosis, change gradually by undergoing a series of molts and insect molts when it outgrows its exoskeleton, which does not stretch and would otherwise restrict the insect's growth. The molting process begins as the insect's epidermis secretes a new epicuticle inside the old one. After this new epicuticle is secreted, the epidermis releases a mixture of enzymes that digests the endocuticle and thus detaches the old cuticle. When this stage is complete, the insect makes its body swell by taking in a large quantity of water or air, which makes the old cuticle split along predefined weaknesses where the old exocuticle was thinnest. 142 Immature insects that go through incomplete metamorphosis are called nymphs, or in the case of dragonflies and damselflies, also naiads. Nymphs are similar in form to the adult except for the presence of wings, which are not developed until adulthood. With each molt, nymphs grow larger and become more similar in appearance to adult insects. This southern hawker dragonfly molts its exoskeleton several times during its life as a nymph, shown as the final molt to become a winged adult. Eclosion. Complete metamorphosis. Main article, holometabolism. Gulf fritillary life cycle. An example of holometabolism. Holometabolism, or complete metamorphosis, is where the insect changes in four stages: an egg or embryo, a larva, a pupa, and the adult or imago. In these species, an egg hatches to produce a larva, which is generally worm-like in form. This worm-like form can be one of several varieties: a ruciform caterpillar-like, scarabeiform grub-like, campodeiform elongated, flattened and active, elateriform wireworm-like, or vermiform maggot-like. The larva grows and eventually becomes a pupa, a stage marked by reduced movement and often sealed within a cocoon. There are three types of pupae: obtect, exarrate or coarctate. Obtect pupae are compact, with the legs and other appendages enclosed. Exarrate pupae have their legs and other appendages free and extended. Coarctate pupae develop inside the larval skin. 151 Insects undergo considerable change in form during the pupal stage and emerge as adults. Butterflies are a well-known example of insects that undergo complete metamorphosis, although most insects use this life cycles. Some insects have evolved this system to hypermetamorphosis. Some of the oldest and most successful insect groups, such Endopterygota, use a system of complete metamorphosis. 143 Complete metamorphosis is unique to a group of certain insect orders, including Diptera, Lepidoptera and Hymenoptera. This form of development is exclusive and not seen in any other arthropod. Senses and communication. Many insects possess very sensitive and, or specialized organs of perception. Some insects, such as bees, can perceive ultraviolet wavelengths, or detect polarized light, while the antennae of male moths can detect the pheromones of female moths over distances of many kilometers. The yellow paper wasp Polistes versicolor is known for its wagging movements as a form of communication within the colony. It can waggle with a frequency of 106 plus or minus 21. A narrow range of frequencies related to the frequency of the sounds they can produce. Mosquitoes have been found to hear up to 2. Mycetophilidae. Diptera and the beetle families Lampyridae, Phengotidae, Elateridae and Staphylinidae are bioluminescent. The most familiar group are the fireflies, beetles of the family Lampyridae. Some species are able to control this light generation to produce flashes. The function varies, with some species using them to attract mates, while others use them to lure prey. Cave-dwelling larvae of Arachnocampa mycetophilidae, fungus gnats glow to lure small flying insects into sticky strands of silk. Some fireflies of the genus Photurus mimic the flashing of female Photinus species to attract males of that species, which are then captured and devoured. The colors of emitted light vary from dull blue Orphelia fultoni, Mycetophilidae, to the familiar greens and the rare reds Phrixothrix timani, Phengotidae. Most insects, except some species of cave crickets, are able to perceive light and dark. Many species have acute vision capable of detecting minute movements. The eyes may include simple eyes or ocelli, as well as compound eyes of varying sizes. Many species are able to detect light in the infrared, ultraviolet and the visible light wavelengths. Color vision has been demonstrated in many species, and phylogenetic analysis suggests that UV green-blue trichromacy existed from at least the Devonian period between 416 and 359 million years ago. Sound production and hearing. Insects were the earliest organisms to produce and sense sounds. Insects make sounds mostly By mechanical action of appendages in grasshoppers and crickets, this is achieved by stridulation. Cicadas make the loudest sounds among the insects by producing and amplifying sounds with special modifications to their body and musculature. The African cicada Brevisana brevis has been measured at 1067. Very low sounds are also produced in various species of Coleoptera, Hymenoptera, Lepidoptera, Mantodea and Neuroptera. These low sounds are simply the sounds made by the insect's movement through microscopic stridulatory structures located on the insect's muscles and joints. The normal sounds of the insect moving are amplified and can be used to warn or communicate with other insects. Most sound-making insects also have tympanal organs that can perceive airborne sounds. Some species in Hemiptera, such as the Coryxids water boatman, are known to communicate via underwater sounds. Most insects are also able to sense vibrations transmitted through surfaces. Communication using surface-borne vibrational signals is more widespread among insects because of size constraints in producing airborne sounds. Insects cannot effectively produce low-frequency sounds, and high-frequency sounds tend to disperse more in a dense environment such as foliage, so insects living in such environments communicate primarily using substrate-borne vibrations. The mechanisms of production of vibrational signals are just as diverse as those for producing sound in insects. Some species use vibrations for communicating within members of the same species, such as to attract mates, as in the songs of the shield bug Nezura viridula. Vibrations can also be used to communicate between entirely different species. Lycaenid gossamer-winged butterfly caterpillars, which are myrmecophilus living in a mutualistic association with ants, communicate.